lot of hang-ups. But baby, please don't hang up. I'm only hungover, 'cause I tried to stay drunk. And I'm a dreamer, 'cause I don't wanna wake up. But you know that I love you, 'cause you can't fake love. I just call to say something, and I should've known that this would be like talking into a toy telephone. What are you thinking? Throw me a bone. Please don't say you'll be better off alone.
Thanks, Matt. This is great. You can check me out on, I'm like on Jordan Gallen on Spotify, and then I also have this other band that I used to have called Dopo Yume, which some, I forget if this is a song from that or whatever. Yeah. I'm gonna get a drink.
Woo!
Yes!
Jordan Gallen on the keys, everybody. That sounded phenomenal. Great songwriter. Check out his music. I'm just going to read one line. It's my book, 1 Year. I wrote one line every day for a year. I do this every show. I'm going to read one line. Today's line, April 3rd. April 3rd. Flowers of Remake. Flowers of Remake. That's the era we're living in. We're in the Flowers of Remake era. Give it up for Jason King. Is going to play some electric guitar on the Stratocaster on the Sunburst Stratocaster. Oh, sick. Awesome.
Are you playing off this?
Yeah. Here, I'll sign it. Let me sign it.
Is it on?
Yeah.
The volume, check the volume on.
Yeah.
Are you in the,
cool.
Oh yeah, play it.
Yeah, let's see how loud it is. Second one.
Let me start.
Okay, pause it. Yeah. Okay, I usually do stand up. You guys know that. I usually do stand up, but I made a song yesterday and it made me really excited. So I was like, you know what? Let me do that instead. And I had a show today, so I figured out everything I need to figure out. So that's cool. You can hit it now, Matt.
Woo! Yeah!
If I do this, we can raise the volume. On the mic. I don't know yet. We'll find out.
I want to keep my dreams.
So this is the second verse I didn't write. So I'm going to do a guitar solo here instead.
Watson up now that the guitar.
Oh, sick, yeah. Dude.
Yeah.
Let's get Watson. Let me just.
Yeah.
I
have
one.
Thank you.
Hell yeah, sounds great.
Nope. I gotta remember the lyrics. I wrote it yesterday. Yeah. It's fine.
Yeah, you're good.
Huh?
Hello?
Should be working.
Okay. What is it on YouTube? What is it?
Nighttime
Montage. Okay. Who does that? Do you want to find out here?
My tune's short. It's kind of simple. It's alright. It's a first draft.
Woo! All right.
The great Aiden Watson here in the late night hour. Thank you, Jordan Galland. Thank you. Have a great night. All right. Can we get Debasery up? Is Debasery ready, or do you need a minute? All right, let's get the great Debasery hosting an open mic April 19th at the TVI in Bushwick, I guess. You got to go to this open mic. It's the hottest open mic. Check it out. We're super stoked to have Debasery with us. Give us a round of applause for Debasery.
Yeah, I'm having an open mic at TVI on April 19th.
What's that?
I did just post the flyer on my Instagram, Debasery. I'm unusually going to be singing along to a song by Sky Ferreira. If anyone knows who she is, please, come on. If you don't, with you. She's literally imprisoned by Capitol Records right now, so fuck Capitol Records. Yeah. She's been imprisoned by them since she was like 20 years old, and she hasn't been able to release her second album.
Damn.
They're literally contractually like aggressing her. Mm. It's really fucked up. Anyways, I loved her when I was 14 and 15 years old, and yeah, this song is her song, so.
Oh shit, hold on just one second. Sorry.
It's okay. It's called Nighttime, My Time. It was my Instagram bio, Nighttime My Time, back in like 2015, so, yeah. I have the lyrics here just in case, you know. Woo!
I'm trying.
Go check out Debauchery 419 at TVI. That was wonderful. I loved it. Give it up for Debauchery. Yeah. Singing for us. All right, let's get Ed Pankoff up. Can we get Ed Pankoff finally? He's going to read a poem for us. Ed Pankoff.
Woo!
So I think I started doing performances here relatively long ago. You know, like right after it got started, right, Matt?
Yeah, you were here.
Like, not quite at the beginning, but right alongside.
Yeah, October.
Yeah, right, and started September, right?
Yes.
Right. Well, see, after pretty much coming here every week, I've reached like a certain point where I realized I've pretty much done everything I've wanted to do. But there's one thing I haven't done yet, and that was just read a simple poem. So this is going to be my last actual performance, I think, because after this, I kind of don't want to do it anymore. This will be my last performance for the foreseeable future at the Easy Paradise Open Mic on Mondays. You'll still see me around here. I'll say hello. I'll watch you. Nowhere Express. We don't all sleep on the same bed. What makes you think you know how I wake up? Perhaps you may realize we have boarded the Nowhere Express a long, long time ago. But you haven't arrived at your station yet. Rather, face your judgment of me, fellow passenger, than face my own. I'm sure you feel the same. I mean, people get on so that they can get off. But do they really get off? Aren't we always on board the Nowhere Express? Can you even remember boarding this train? This train which replaces its cages, it rearranges according to whatever gets subsumed by some grander condition. The Nowhere Express, where the food gives indigestion and leaves you wanting more. The faces of your fellow passengers just as dejected as yours. And sometimes you wonder, as you dream at night, if we all sleep in the same bed. The Nowhere Express has arrived at its destination. All aboard. Next stop, right here. Nowhere. Edward Pankoff, everybody! Retiring!
I'm done!
Retiring.
I'm done.
I think it's like a Jay-Z retiring. I think there will still be... But give it up one more time for Edward Pankoff. The Nowhere Express, we're riding the Nowhere Express right now. All aboard! Can we get Galvin up? Is Galvin... Can we get some poetry from Galvin?
Yeah.
Great, great poet. We're very excited to have them here. And get ready, because it's great poetry coming at you.
So recently I've been reading like a lot of poems from the new book that you can't get yet, but now I'm going to read some poems from the book that you can get.
Woo!
Like The Strand, whatever, just go there, it's there. It's called Ugly Time. Anyway, here's a poem called On Design. It's an ugly time to be alive. All day, two enormously fat guys stand on the corner outside my apartment smoking. But I'm so distracted by the hideous condo that's like going up next door that I can't watch them while I masturbate. This one is called The Song About Being a Person. Thank you. This is called The Song About Being a Person. A doctor instructed me to do a stretch that involves flattening a line of ants with my ass. She was very specific. Not spiders or beetles, she insisted. She almost certainly prescribed the stretch because she is sexually excited by ants. Under her white coat, she's probably covered with them. her as a doctor because of this. I relate to her more as a person. In fact, it reminds me of that chorus from that Bob Dylan song about being a person that goes, "It would bring me to orgasm if my cock was covered with ants." This is a book you could buy now. Fucking hell. Okay. It's called "I Heard She Was Fired from Catholic Arby's." But I looked all over the place and I couldn't find Arby anywhere. Maybe this is why I feel what I've heard is called malaise. I climbed every historic building in town and nothing was on top of them. Now most of them have been demolished to make way for buildings that lack even the possibility of something on top of them. That lack is worse than disappointment. It's depleting my vitamin D. To someone with a vitamin deficiency, human genitalia is invisible. Nothing is more erotic than confirming by touch the existence of something you can't see, except when it's just what you expect. Alright, one more. This is called "The Gutter on the House of My Life." Time is the gutter on the house of my life, draining away all my non-sexy memories. I thought I had one non-sexy memory of riding a speedboat between two yachts that were so close together they ripped the hull off the speedboat. But then someone told me recently this actually happened to Indiana Jones. I was disappointed until I realized that if I generate enough sexy memories to clog the gutter, I may become immortal. Thank you.
Yes! Yeah. Woo.
Galvin is great. Buy the book. Fantastic. Thank you for reading your poetry with us, Galvin. We love it. We love it. We love it. Let's get James Jewell, WL. James WL is going to play some music for us, I believe. We got some great entertainment. We're in the wee hours. We're in late night territory. It's where it gets fun and relaxed, and it's New York, and it's never sleeps. So we're going all night. James Jewell, WL.
Hello, everybody. I'm James. I go by Jewel as my artist name, and I'm here to play some piano music for y'all. Hope you all enjoy. This next piece is a piece I wrote myself. It's called Infinite Railroad. Hope you all enjoy. This is my first time performing at an open mic.
Woo!
Yeah. I don't know.
you want to find my Instagram, it's real_JEWL.
Woo!
Yeah. God damn, that sounded good as hell. Give it up for James Jewel WL. That was beautiful. Really nice. All right, let's get Canoe Reads up. The great Canoe Reads. Probably just in from kayaking, maybe. Who knows? Are you playing?
Yeah, this is a guitar today. Did you plug in, or?
I can plug in.
Do you want to stand, or?
We got a few more acts coming up. We got some great entertainment. Get another drink at the bar. We got a 2-drink minimum. Let's enjoy it. Let's have a great time.
Stage name is Canoe Reads. I like to canoe. I like to read poetry. If you ever want to do either, hit me up. We'll go out on the water. I won't kill you. I got life jackets. I was going to do some poetry, but I don't feel... I do like sad emo poetry. I don't feel like being sad on the car ride back to Queens. So I'm going to do a little country vibe for you guys.
Yeah.
Swallow my pride.
and chase it down with your big old smile. I heard you laughing again. I know it's been a while. You found yourself a better man.
I just make an announcement. I think everybody needs to know. It's important. Fido Babushka is here. That's it. That's all. There's no pressure. Nothing. We've got some great ears.
Oh, yes. Yeah, like my noise.
This is system lore.
All right. We got great people. Can we get, is plain air out there?
Yeah.
Let's get plain air out. That's why.
We got some great, great stuff. I mean, this is the topper. If you think what you've seen so far has been phenomenal, just wait till you see these closing acts. We're going to blow this place apart. I promise you. I fucking swear to God. Yeah! Yes, yes, 1 a.m. on Monday morning, yes! Fuck the jobs. Fuck the man. Fuck work.
Fuck the man.
That's right. This is New York. We want to work. We rob people.
Do you want to stand?
Yeah.
Do you
know the answer? Yep. We're rich. We're rich. We don't work.
Yes. Yeah. We're fucking rich. We're rich.
I found 2 nickels on that table, so yes, I'm also rich. Song about growing up in a very religious, conservative upbringing in the South, and about it's about the things that you are able to leave and the things that you can't. It's all South Carolina.
There's a church on every corner. One of them was mine. I'm pacing through the driveway as I'm packing up the car. I have to travel quick and travel far. My father holds me tightly. My mother starts to cry. He says, Father, please be with him. May you never leave his side. If I step outside where the world is wide, are you scared I'll lose my way? I have to leave South Carolina. Will you ever feel like home? I'm both ashamed and proud to be from there, but I must roam. It seems like everyone that you look up to all share a very different point of view. when you choose to stand for justice for the ones we marginalize, you stand opposed to those who once were heroes in your eyes. As I barrel down the highway past the Mason-Dixon line, I think of what I've had to leave behind. Like the feeling that you're certain and the feeling you belong when you're in a congregation singing hymns and gospel songs. If I step outside what you had in mind, will you think I lost my way? I have to leave South Carolina. Will you ever feel like home? I'm both ashamed and proud to be from there, but I must roam, I must roam. Start another life across the sea. You may go to many places, but you only come from one. No matter what you father, you will always be a son. And that part of you is constant like the color of your eyes. Those gospel songs will always make me cry. Even if I leave the table and unlearn what was taught, God is always with me, whether he exists or not. Yes, my faith is blind, there is no other kind. What's the point of faith if you can see? I have to leave South Carolina. Will you ever feel like home? I'm both ashamed and proud to be from there. I must roam, Lord, Lord, I got to leave South Carolina. Will you ever feel like home? Lord, Lord, I'm both ashamed and proud to be from there. I must roam, I must roam. If y'all enjoyed that, definitely follow me on Instagram, plainair.music, P-L-E-I-N, air.music. Thank y'all. Woo!
Wow, that sounded great. Plain Air, really amazing. Sounded great at the DI. And the was that nylon strings?
No.
Shit, it sounded...
strings.
Wow, damn. Beautiful! Sound like nylon strings for Plain Air! Check out Plain Air Music on Instagram. Alright, can we get... We're going to have Emma Samuelson come up, play some piano for us. I think making an open mic debut, so give it up for Emma Samuelson.
Hi guys. This is a song that I'm currently working on writing, and I'll be piano. Thank you.
Absolutely phenomenal. Emma Samuelson, everybody. Yeah. Classical. Shoot the piano player. That's classical. Classical. I feel like that was classical. So good. All right, can we get Joel Ramirez up? Is Joel Ramirez in the house? We got just a few performers left. Thank you all for hanging out. I'm feeling great. I feel jazzed. Joel Ramirez.
Yeah. Thank you, guys.
Oof. Yeah!
I'm happy everyone left, right? Got the real artist here.
Woo!
Yeah. Chunk on a Monday night. Artist. Not degenerates, artist.
Exactly.
Sick. Yo, Matt, has anyone told you you look like Johnny Knoxville?
Oh, nice.
With the hair and glasses.
Sick, thank you.
You should shoot yourself. Not kill yourself. Shoot yourself. Calm down. You guys don't know? Like the stunt that got Johnny Knoxville famous, he put on a bulletproof vest and shot himself. Right? Genius. And I think Matt should try it out. No? Maybe put his own parody. Maybe do a live the next mic. I'm sure it'll kill. Hello. Sick. So I saw an interview of Johnny Knoxville talking about this specific stunt. He said he didn't want to like shoot himself in the first place. He wanted to find someone to shoot him. I'm done talking about this. Sick. Where's Matt? Oh, there he is. I literally just stayed here just for my purpose. Like, so many doubts just to leave. No one's paying attention. I'm kidding, guys. Thank you. Your song was great. Fuck, South Carolina? Right? Yeah, I remember. I was paying attention.
Yeah.
Yes. You gonna tag me, Matt, Instagram?
Yeah.
Yes.
Woo! Woo!
I guess I'll do a bit. You guys remember skipping? Yeah, you need to bring that back, right? Right, just because one older kid called you a fairy, we're gonna stop doing it? Because that older kid, he was a skipper. Until someone called him a fairy. And I'm sure you called someone a fairy for skipping. Like, it's gotta stop, it's a whole cycle. No? Like, skipping? Dude, like, how you guys skip? That shit is nuance. It's soft on your feet, light on your joints. You feel like you don't get tired. Like, call it magical, but that shit is... Oh, fuck, I fucked it up. Call it fairy-like, but that shit is magical. Sick. Crazy momentum. You get crazy momentum when you skip. You fly to your destination. Like, Black Sons and Latinos, we never be late again. We just start skipping. Just saying, skipping can end stereotypes. In the future. I do think that though, like everyone starts skipping all throughout the city. Imagine everyone in Times Square just skipping around.
Yeah.
And there'll still be people walking. You have to skip past them. It's like, look at this faggot walking. Yeah, you guys hate me. I had to drop the F-bomb. I'm talking about skipping, guys. I had to drop the F-bomb once. Alright, I'm ending there, guys. Thank you.
Yes!
Yeah. All right, dude.
Joe Ramirez, ending it on the hate speech. Just kidding, I mean, I don't know. Who knows? Who knows what the rules are anymore? Apparently you can just say whatever the fuck you want, but it's great. Give it up one more time for Joe Ramirez. Come on. All right, can we get Miles Toe up?
Yeah.
Miles Toe, we just have a couple more people. Are you Reed? Okay, all right. We just have a couple more people. If you think that I'm ignoring you, send me a message. Or don't light anything on fire or make your whole set about how you hate me and how I'm not putting you on or anything. Let's get Miles Toe up to make us all laugh.
Yeah. What's up, everybody? You guys doing good?
Yeah.
You guys are all wonderful performers, by the way. Clap up for yourselves.
Yes, yes.
I can't do poetry. I have to use my own fucking charismatic ways. I was a creative writer. I wish I could write poetry. I can't. I deal with my trauma like cocaine. That's what I usually do.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Untrue. Yeah. Do you guys want to hear? Do you guys want to hear like a new story or like old jokes?
New story.
New story. Okay. I literally flew in from Minneapolis today. I went to go to Minneapolis. Yeah, I went to, huh?
The Midwest.
Midwest. Fucking hate it. I fucking, worst place to ever. It should nuke everything in that side. There's only two places that count. It's New York and LA. That's it.
Yes.
The middle, just racism and fucking corn. That's what it is. All right? I went to Minneapolis. I flew back today. So this was what happened today. I decided today to go to a Panda Express in a Minnesota airport, which was one of the worst decisions I ever made in my entire life. You guys ever been to Panda Express?
It's not good at all. You ever been to Pan Express in the Midwest? It doesn't, shouldn't exist. It shouldn't fucking exist. Let me tell you what happened. I had two thoughts when I ate that Panda Express at the airport. One, I was like, damn, this shit's expensive. And two, what am I doing with my life? You know what I'm saying? Right in that moment, I had this, right? So the whole thing, the reason why it was so weird is that I ate the Panda Express. Then I got on the flight, right? You guys know what happens when you get on a flight with Panda Express? You get fucking diarrhea 35,000 feet up in the air, right? You guys ever been to an airport bathroom or an airplane bathroom, right? Woo! It's not made for 6 foot black men. I don't know if you know this. It's made for, I don't know, children or just little people. I don't know what it's made for. But just imagine my big black ass stuck in the air like this for like 35 to 40 minutes, right? And when you're shitting in an airplane, you have like an existential crisis. There's like a moment where you're just like, is God real? Like in that moment, you really question everything, right? Because you're already anxious. Because everyone knows you're taking a shit in the airplane, right? Because the bathroom is in the back, right? And we all do like the judgment walk, like, who's this fucker? He walks past everyone, like, oh, I hate this guy. That's the part. I was that guy walking through, and I'm stuck in the bathroom. So they're like, oh, that guy's in there, and he's taking a shit. Gross. You know what I'm saying, right? Yeah. So I'm like thinking things. I'm thinking like weird things. I'm like, what if there's turbulence? You know? That's like the thought. What if there's turbulence? Right? Because what happens when there's turbulence, gravity just shuts off. That's what happens, right?
Save the turtles.
Right, yes. But then, if you're shitting and gravity just shuts off, the shit just goes up with you. You know what I'm saying? I can't think that way. I flushed the toilet, and I'm not going to lie, I thought my balls were going to fuck down through the airplane. I thought it was... So it was the worst experience ever. Don't ever go to Pan Express in the airport. It's like the worst thing ever. Don't ever do it. Like, you could do crack. Like, if you're right now, like, I should smoke crack or go to the Pan Express Midwest, smoke crack. Just smoke. Get high. You might as well, you know? Get fucking high. I went to a Midwest funeral. That's what I went to. My friend, her fucking her aunt died, and they're Catholic. Any Catholics in here? You Catholic? Okay. You guys cry a lot. You Catholic?
Kinda.
Okay. I don't know. I've been to black funerals. Black funerals are fun. They're fun. You know what happens at a black funeral? We go like, oh, they're dead. We talk shit. We drink Hennessy. That's it. That's all we do. And then sometimes we'll fuck each other. That's what we do at black funerals. Just find some random, oh, you're my cousin? Probably. We fuck. It just happens. But why is there so much cousin fucking? Exactly. It's a black funeral. I asked the same question, sir. White funerals are different. White funerals, you guys just cry. You guys just cry, and you guys don't downward spiral. I don't know what that is. I don't get that, right? This girl at the funeral, she was like, oh, thank you for being here. And I was like, you're welcome. And she's like, we're going to just sit here and think about her loss. I'm like, she died a week ago. What is this? Can we just figure this out? I think if people died in my life, I would immediately just drink. You know, you got to drink. Why would you cry? I don't cry. Last time I cried was when I saw Up. That's the last time I cried. And after that, I was like, I hate crying. I don't want to cry ever again. I fucking hate crying. Your eyes are wet. It's like, what? This is stupid. I just want to not cry anymore. Okay, that was a new shit. I'm going to try some old shit. You guys broke?
Yep.
Yeah, bro? You guys are artists. Poets. Thank God.
No. Rich.
You get rich?
Rich.
How rich are you?
Rich, rich.
Rich, rich, rich. Like, rich, 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 rich.
What is rich, 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 rich?
Like, billion.
You're a billionaire?
Yeah.
So what the fuck are you doing here? Because if I was a billionaire, I would have bought this place and burned it to death. I would just, actually, you know what? If I was a billionaire, I would just buy MSG and make people listen to my poetry. That's what I would do.
Yeah.
I'd pay everyone to sit there and be like, all right, here's one line. There's one line, but I just paid people $1 billion. Listen to my line. Your song was pretty good.
Woo!
Not yeah,
she
wrote it. They wrote it.
Yeah, it's very erotic. I like it.
Erotic.
It's good. It was like you rubbed the ground. You like doing a leg thing. I know what, back there, I was like, they're looking directly at me, but like there's a light here, so I'm like, I'm crazy. You know what I'm saying? That's why I thought you were like singing towards
you're crazy,
me.
You're crazy.
Yeah, I was like, oh, they're singing right towards me, but there's a light here. I can't see any of your faces.
Yeah,
so
no, you're crazy.
I'm insane. Okay, being broke. Oh. Yes, I'm kind of broke right now. I lost my job when I wrote this joke, so we're gonna pretend I didn't have money, right? Lost my job. I used to work as a barista at a coffee shop in a white neighborhood. You might have heard of it. It's called Bed-Stuy. You guys heard of it? So.
up and coming white neighborhood. Here's the thing about working in a white neighborhood at a coffee shop. Whenever white people order coffee, it always kind of sounds racist a little bit, right? Hear me out, right? I'm at behind the counter, this lady comes up to me, she goes, "Hey, Miles, can I get a vanilla latte and a large coffee black?" I was like, "All right, it's gonna be $5 white. Like, why are we saying our racist, you know?" I asked her, I was like, "Hey, miss, that sounded kind of crazy when you said that. Can you like revamp that and I'll make it sound better?" She's like, "All right, you're right. Can I get a vanilla latte and a large coffee without milk and sugar?" And I was like, "Thank you." She's like, "You're welcome, you dirty monkey." I was like, "What the fuck is that?" But I shot her. That's how I lost my job. It's crazy. Yeah, it's kind of hate crap. You look like the guy from Weezer.
Yeah!
All right, cool. I'm out of here. See you.
Guy from Weezer. You didn't know that. I'm Rivers Cuomo. I'm hosting this now. I quit Weezer. We're putting out, we put out like eight.
You proctor.
We put out a green album, then a blue album, then a Maladroit album, and you know, with the Muppets, and now I'm hosting open mic, and it's beautiful. I love it. I love my life now. I love my fucking life. Money life. Woo! All right, we have just a couple more. I am so sorry, I apologize to everyone for making you suffer all night for your little moment in the spotlight, but I know we all love it, we all share it, and it's equal. That's what's nice about it. Everybody gets an equal slice of the pie. We all share. It's not like some big ego trip where we're worshiping rock gods. We are the rock gods. Speaking of which, can we get Reed Kerkerkerwitz? Is that right? I'm sorry.
Reed Kerkerkerwitz.
What's up, Manhattan?
Woo!
It's Kerkowitz, Reed Kerkowitz.
Kerkowitz, sorry.
I'm gonna do some poems.
Woo!
Okay. I don't know if this is true for everyone, but for me, the limitless feed does not exceed memory. I don't think about this on purpose. I think I should quit itching my ear in customer service. To cure screen addiction, those who've learned nothing open books. I wouldn't stop masturbating if it meant you would come back. Did you see bears scan the valleys from the high cliffs? They download mini-maps just like us. Did you watch the speedrunners seek a democracy of perfection? You need some baseline knowledge to understand anything. I have the perfect video for you. Moose above ground pool raids, brutal shootouts, epic trick shots, Wild West cosplay, elite tag, gas station reviews, good things happen to those who hurry to Staples. Ketchup casserole, so much has already happened. Plato's afterlife, where the joke is the brain is a concentration of nerves made possible by bilateral structure. How does symmetry act? I forget. I don't feel symmetrical.
Woo!
Automatic writing on a painting of a gilded gold Our Lady perfectly inlaid with all. This method was vital. In my early days of isolation, why did I operate at all? Or am I only unorganized? So many groups to choose from, but only some are true and accessible and late enough for you. Symmetry is balance. It undercuts roses and not roses, less reflective of moments than preservational. Mind control is difficult. Distracted, my own is scattered, unutterable, mainly in its trouble. To go back appears foundational. It all appears stretched, constant, clawing at a widening gap. You do much without even automata, but pure motion, your body is a fiber of damp.
Yes!
Woo!
Thank you. Okay, this one, this poem has a title. It's called Mom Calls Crying to Say I'm Becoming Dad. My cancer is my father's beer belly, tobacco throat, and sense of smile at everyone you meet because they might be Jesus. He said that walking to the dollar store, and I said Jesus might come back ugly as a trick. And he said Jesus is beautiful and never think of anyone as ugly. Where else can that dead mortal live but in my esophagus tightening, my stomach tightening? No one taught him until the last days he could stand to stand and kneel and gather and come back up, how maple seeds twirl on a wing weighed down. Waiting with him for the free chemotherapy fan, he launched handfuls of fleeting angels and asked how anyone could pretend there was no God.
Woo!
Thank you.
Yes!
Thank you. Let's do, it's not so bad out here. This one's dedicated to my friend Jacob Spiegelhoff. Yard after yard of fires, riding gasoline streams like the gangster tip, we doused in chlorine water and leaves from the above-ground pool where we capsized ships and collapsible patio tables where Great Aunt Margie and I ate coffee cake together for the last time and watched the sun crawl over her marigolds, and she actually said crawl. And sewers where the pipe shrinks to block the littlest siblings, where we looked up at the cars rattling the drain cover, where the quarry company demolished and relocated Charles Street, where the rainwater rushed, we crawled backwards. Where on ice-cracked sidewalks, I pulled a boy who would betray me on his skateboard by his teeth, and the old man we didn't know smiled. And where we picked up string instruments and drums and wrote songs in the garage, and the neighbors walked over to watch us and cheered because they knew of what we sang. I'll do
yes.
one more.
Thank Woo!
This last poem is forthcoming from Dream Boy booklet.
Oh.
It's called The Second Law of Thermodynamics.
Yes.
I'm a man of the law. I have nothing to sell you anymore. I gave it all to my mom. She took it out back and mowed the lawn because I was off at college. Now I'm a man of the mall. I sell myself in bathroom stalls. I loved the law. My mom decapitated a rabbit who lived below our lawn. She cried, but she will never go to jail. Thank you. You can follow me on Instagram, Sweeto Rito. I'm going to be reading at the Debasery open mic at TBI on the 19th as well, so that's cool.
Yeah.
Thanks so much, man.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Phenomenal.
Read Kerkerowitz. 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 Yeah, that was great. I'm sorry I put you on so insufferably late. That was wonderful. Great, great, great stuff. Yes, fantastic. One more time for Reed Kerkerowitz. Fantastic. And it was in Dream Boy Book Club. Yeah. What a dope-ass fucking magazine. Dream Boy Book Club. Hell yeah. That was great. Reed Kerkerowitz. All right. I think we just have Joe Levy, and then we're going to have a few words from Giorgio Rosa for our astrological fucking forecast. So let's get Joe Levy to make us laugh our fucking balls off.
Thank you, Matt. Woo! Thank you guys for hanging out. I appreciate that. You guys are awesome, baby.
Woo!
Let's have some fun.
Yeah.
Yo, Mom was talking about shit earlier.
Yeah.
About diarrhea. Yo, you ever like walk in a bathroom and like you're surprised it smells like shit? You know, you're like, yo, who's shit in here? That's crazy. Like you're surprised for some reason. Like, yo, why does it smell like shit? Who's shit in here? Like, oh, it was me. Fuck, I smell like shit. But like, yo, it's sometimes crazy. Like, you ever walk in the bathroom, like there's such good air freshener, it smells too good? Like, yo, what is that, lavender? What's going on here? Vanilla? Come on. Trying to do some business, man. It's fun, you guys all came from the Midwest, I'll hate your parents and shit. I go very religious, man. I was an Orthodox Jew. Yeah, man. I couldn't even watch wrestling as a kid because it was too violent. You know how crazy this? I was like, hey, Joe, you can't watch wrestling, it's too violent. Yeah, then one day, she caught me watching WWE, right? So as a punishment, she beat the shit out of me. You know, no chair, just a belt and a ladder. She's like, no violence in this house. I thought my mom was John Cena. She's like, you can't see me. I'm like, you have a black eye, no shit. You know? And then, this is embarrassing, the next day, she'd come watching porn. Boy, was I sore. You know, I was like, fuck in the ass of my mom. Like, Jesus, I gotta smoke the whole pack? No. I did watch Dora the Explorer as a kid. Not Diego, just Dora. Bro, you know what? Hey, fuck, why does Dora always ask these questions? I don't get it. She's like, where should we go? The bridge or the river? It's like, I don't know, you're the explorer. Why are you asking me? You never see a pilot do that. Like, I'll be a pilot for anything. What are you guys thinking, the clouds or the mountain? You know, you guys wanna crash? Also, fucking, Dora doesn't say like swiper, no swiping, you know? What kind of shit is that? What kind of lesson is that to teach kids? I take it to heart, you know? I grew up in a Jewish neighborhood. Remember one day, this guy just steal my bike? I was like, Shlomo no stealing, Shlomo no stealing. You know? Hey, took my bike and sold it, you know? I grew up in Brooklyn, man, it was pretty dangerous. When I was 12 years old, my best friend got kidnapped. Best friend can admit.
Damn.
And here's the worst part of Frank and Kingdom. Like, it's really hard to get all your action figures back. You know? Because he was borrowing them. What am I supposed to do? I was like, yo, Mom, we need to get my best friend back. She's like, who, Jack? I'm like, no, Batman. She's like, oh, stop that. Your friend was one of a kind. But well, technically, limited edition, actually. You know, give it a whole pack. Thank you, man. You know what happened is we were riding home for football, right? We're both on our bikes, and I'm like, yo, bro, I gotta get home. If I get home past 6 o'clock, my mom's gonna be pissed at me, right? So I rode home, he was alone, he got kidnapped. I said, yo, it's a good thing I did go home late. Like, I did go home early. Cause like, my mom was upset, I got home 20 minutes later. Imagine I got home like 2 days later. Damn, that would've been bad, you know? I think I'm an anger problem. Like, you ever get upset for no reason? Like, I was on a date with this girl, we were getting ice cream, date was going great. Midway through, I'm like, God damn it, they gave me the wrong sprinkles. I wanted rainbow, this is chocolate. She's like, yo, what's wrong with you? Like, no, I wanted chocolate sprinkles, you know? Yo, can I get real with you guys for a second? Like, this is yeah. Real, man. This girl, and this is some real shit, because girls go through a lot. This girl told me, she's like, Joe, I think you're great. I'm a little worried. The last time I was with somebody was not consensual, you know? It's a real shit happened to me, man. And as a guy, when the girl says, you gotta take it seriously. You gotta, like, you know, go with her, make sure she's comfortable. And we ended up having sex, but it wasn't my best performance. I'll be honest. I was very, like, shy. I wasn't, like, with it all the time. I didn't give my best performance. Afterwards, I'm like, hey, man. I'm like, hey, girl. I'm sorry. That wasn't great. And she's like, oh, it's fine. I wish the last guy came that quick. You know what I mean? All right, that's what you know what I'm trying to say. You know, because she wished the last guy came quick like I did. All right. I warned you guys. You know what I mean? I didn't fucking do it. I think she broke up because I got pretty smelly feet. I'll be honest, man. Like, okay, like, my feet smell so bad. Like, if I'm with a girl and I'm taking my shoes off and I don't want her to smell my feet, I have to fart. That's the only option. Like, my feet smell so bad. When I was younger, I was a lose at hide and seek. You know? It's like all my friends were tracking, like, their dogs and I was an edible in a luggage. Alright, thank you guys. Bye, thank you.
Woo!
Yes!
Joe Levy bringing it hard in the late hours. It's late night, baby. Late night New York. This is as good as it gets. They can't stop us. This is New York. You can do anything you want. You are above the law. There are no laws. You do whatever the fuck you... And we're going to get a little astrological forecast to clean us out. Can we get a big round of applause for the living legend, Giorgio Rosa?
Hi. Yes, thank you. After being driven from this city so many times, only a select few hosts like you, Matt Proctor, said yes. We are the reals, they are the fakes. Goodbye, Jack.
Woo!
Wow. You know, do I... Do I sense a Sagittarius? what is your sign, madame?
Me?
Yes.
Sagittarius,
your cause is just right. Matt, they won't let me sing, they said, from the astrology rock opera musical.
Do your rock opera musical, definitely.
The astrology rock opera musical.
Yes.
Wow. You know, because we say, you know, because the Sagittarius song is very long, there's like 6 or 7 verses to it because it goes on, because Sagittarius actually becomes like the archer in the sky. It's oh archer in the sky, oh archer, yes you fly, oh Sagittarius, you know your cause is just, but
yeah.
We have like a little like, you know, little like rhythm guitar and everything, and it's like, but that is the astrology rock opera musical, because your cause is just Sagittarius. Yes, in June of this year, and then in June of next year, there's two milestones. One is actually abroad, where you're doing like, it's funny, like relief work stuff. And then the other one is actually more policy work stuff. I don't even know where this is coming from. That's why they say it's evil. They say, why is he allowed to do the astrology? I finally thought I found a band that wasn't going to sabotage me like all the rest have. But they did again. Mm. What is your sign?
Pisces.
Oh, a Pisces.
Oh, deep, deep lagoon. Oh, blue, 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 blue moon. Oh, Pisces, you passionate fish.
Yeah.
It's part of the astrology rock opera musical, no? Because you are actually Pisces. They say that you and Aries are the most psychic of the signs. And I should say, yes, you are Pisces, the most psychic. Because you have one fish in your heart and one fish in your soul. But it is the hook of Pisces. It is the hook of the fisher person. That hooks in the heart and the soul. So when you actually take your passion and you yoke it to the work you do in the world. Yes, yes, that's right. Snap, 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 said the poet. And then he left town. When you take that hook, then you, Pisces, also spiral, 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 spiral in the sea as Aries does in the sky. Pisces, that's why you fly so high. Yes, I saw nods out in the audience tonight, Mike and Matt. I was called you Mike. I saw nods in the audience. That means 100% truth in those rooms. You know that? Okay. And what is back there? What is your sign?
Me?
Yeah.
A Virgo.
Oh, that's my sign too. You know, this is why they banned the astrology rock opera musical. Oh, great big Mother Magura. Luckiest star.
Woo!
They say you're Virgo the virgin, but you're hardly a virgin by far. With that, I say thank you to your host, thank you to the house, thank you to the bathtub gym, thank you. Good night.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you all. Wow. We really made it happen
with the
group. I think it's the time of my life.
No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear. Open mic, April 3rd, 2023. Another one for the books. We did it. We were accosted by people in the audience. They were lighting things on fire. They tried to stop us. They couldn't fucking do it. They could never fucking stop the open mic. And we will not put on your fucking hate speech. We will not put on your fiction about all of the fucking things in your head. We're having a great time every Monday night. We'll be back next Monday for the New York Times National Book Award winning study hall is over. Class is dismissed. Go forth and be merry. Let me clean you out. Ruby Cower. Chick Cower. Take some Ruby Cower. Pete Lindell. Rest in peace, Pete Lindell. Now this night, I can finally wake up. I don't have all the answers. Watching the Gong Show and the open mic rerun simultaneously? Kuzu Daddy says I'm naive! Ah! The job of my life! This way before! Ari Shields in the fucking house! Listen, baby! This show is so hot, it's fucking steaming! Steve! The job of my life! Bill Medley! Righteous Brothers, come on! System!
No.
Ruby, we love you. I will not have you build me into your life when I want. What I want is to build a life with you. To build a life with you. Rivers fall from my mouth. Rivers fall from my mouth. Tears my eyes cannot carry. Come on, Swayze. Good. The time of my life. Woo! Yeah.
joy, spread joy. Poetry, that's your poetry. Down, 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 down